Christmas! It's the special Christmas show with me. Hold on, what button is this? There we go. All right. All right. It's our special Christmas show with me, Jeffrey, and Snitzer, right?
Yep.
You there, Snitz?
I am.
Okay, hello. Hello, and Merry Christmas! What's going on? So, yeah, we were doing a Christmas show.
His hat is weird.
Okay, we're doing a Christmas show because Doogie was doing one with Gia on Magic.
The Oldie Station.
I said, hey, Keith Kennedy, can I do a Christmas show with Jeffrey and Snitzer? And he said, hell no. Oh. And I said, what a Grinch. I said, what a goddamn Grinch on Christmas. So luckily, Rob, our new program director, Eager Beaver, Cream Pie Carl, he said, you guys can do a Christmas show on MMS all you want. So that's what we're doing here today. We're going to be doing a special Christmas show for WMMS. Also, if you're interested, it's on RMG Plus right now. If you want to see this, I'm sitting here with Jeffrey. I just have to know, where did you come from today?
Actually, I came from work.
Work in a chimney? Are you a chimney sweep?
No, I didn't work in a chimney.
Look at that camera, like it looks like
got a mask.
You're covered in soot. Why are you?
I was working in our shop. I was.
What time do you get off?
I would get off till like 4:30. I didn't have a chance to get home.
I know this is Christmas Eve that we're doing this on, but I picked you up at 6. You didn't have time to.
No, I didn't have time to
wet wipe or anything.
Well, of course I wiped my ass, but I just didn't. I mean, everything happened so fast. I had to make sure the wife and kids were taken care of and all that kind of stuff.
What do you mean? How did you prepare them?
I was able to get them dinner.
Oh, you made them dinner. What'd you make?
No, I didn't make them dinner. I got them dinner. That's what I meant.
What'd you get? What was their Christmas dinner?
I forgot.
I forgot. This is Christmas.
Right. I forgot we're taping this for Christmas.
Well, no, you're not supposed to say that. No, nobody's supposed to know this is Wednesday, 2 weeks beforehand.
Okay. No, I just haven't had a chance because we'd planned on I'd planned on visiting my parents and whatnot for Christmas Eve.
So what'd you get your kids for Christmas Eve dinner?
Oh, just got some rallies.
That's always beautiful. The whole family.
And then we're gonna have a nice dinner Christmas tomorrow.
All the family around the big Bufords. It's a beautiful time. So this Christmas show that we're doing, since it's not on the Oldie Station, we'll actually be able to play some cool music. Hopefully it's cool. We let Rob pick it out. So I have to read his hand right here. So here's our first song on our special Christmas show. Merry Christmas to everybody. Rob, this is quite an issue. I don't know if I can. Mr. Satan Xmas? What is this? You don't know. All right. Well, this is a song. This is a rockin' Christmas. This is what we're going to do, rock Christmas
songs.
Heavy
metal Christmas.
Heavy metal Christmas for the Christmas Craptacular on 100.7 WMMS. I guess you'll get some behind the scenes because this is actually the audio show we're doing. So, all right. Good?
Yeah.
Did you quit recording, Snitz?
I did and then jumped right back in.
Oh, okay. So I didn't have to say that. All right, cool.
Mistress for Christmas.
Mistress for Christmas. Oh, Jeffrey.
ACDC. That's the one you couldn't read?
Yes, if that's the problem one, we're gonna have some issues. Okay, so I guess. All right, so now we're going to the next thing. All right, let me get my sheet here.
This is how professionals do it, guys.
This is, the people will be seeing this?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, whatever. Here, this is it. All right, ready, Jeffrey?
Yeah.
All right, and 3, 2, we'll pick a different song. 3, 2, 1. All right, we're back at the Christmas Craptacular here. Jeffrey, get yourself a cold one. Open it up, all right? Oh, you don't have one? Here you go. Got some?
No. I guess it would hurt to have a cold one.
You could have a cold one, Christmas cold one, because... Oh, I hit the TV.
Oh, boy. Oh. Charlie, you're clumsy.
It's a little bit of a disaster.
How many
here.
Christmas cold right. ones have you had already?
Huh? I've not had any. All right. Okay, Jeffrey, so I'm going to teach you how to make a Christmas ale, okay, out of High Life. All right?
Okay. Damn, dude. Oh, what happened?
Oh. That's not like it's recorded on video or anything.
No.
Nobody's going to see that.
We could just switch the chairs out, I think. Well, I'm turning my back. Rob's in the fart box looking at me right now. I don't know if you can see his face. Let's see.
I can see him laughing his ass off.
Is he mad? Rob?
That's not a happy face.
right. Well, okay. Pour a beer here. Kind of explode. The cup broke. The cup broke.
Yikes.
The cup literally broke. How could this go any worse?
These dollar store cups too, or
I don't know. Where'd you get these cheap ass cups? I was trying to make a Christmas cocktail for us, all right?
Okay.
I'm sorry. All right. So, here's what we do, Jeff. We put some High Life in. I got us a little cinnamon. All right. Ooh. This will taste good, right?
Right?
Yeah, cinnamon's good.
All right, a little cinnamon there. Oh, this actually looks pretty nice. A little nutmeg, right? I'm just going off of what I think Christmas is about.
Oh. So,
sounds like Christmas.
Cinnamon, nutmeg.
Yeah.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
These nuts resting on your chin.
Whatever, dude.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah.
The cinnamon stick. There we go. Okay. No, that's a camera there. All right, we got ourselves. Here, this is for you.
Oh
yeah, nice.
Oh, thank you.
All right. Just going to make one more. All right. Good.
Cinnamon stick.
Yeah, we got cinnamon stick in there. How does it taste? Is that a good Christmas ale or is it the worst? I didn't try this beforehand. Not good, huh?
No, I mean, you have to add sugar to the cinnamon.
Oh, it's just
sugar.
That's what you forgot to do.
All right, Jeffrey, I'm sorry. All
that's right, okay. I mean, it's a good first try, Charlie.
Snitz, you only like beer, so no, you're the bad one. Did you drive here, Snitz?
I drove here, yeah.
Oh, I'd pick Jeffrey up.
Oh man, I'm sorry.
Well, Krista.
Actually, when you stir it around a little bit more, it comes out. It tastes a lot. It tastes better.
All right, let me try this here, my Christmas cocktail. Merry Christmas, to everybody that's listening out there.
Yep, Merry Christmas, motherfuckers.
Every time you cuss, we're on WMS. Every time you cuss, Rob's gonna have to edit that out.
Well, I just slipped out.
It's all right. What's your favorite cuss word?
Actually, I'm not gonna say it because I don't wanna.
No, go ahead. He has to edit. I don't have to edit.
I don't wanna make a lot of work for him.
No, it's all right. What's his favorite cuss word? He's saying go for it.
Oh, you mean like shit, con, motherfucker, tits?
Yeah, all those. Yeah. Merry Christmas.
Seven words you can't say on TV or radio for that matter.
All right. So, up next. Oh, up next, one of my Christmas favorites, Jeffrey, for our Christmas playlist.
Which one?
So sit back, get your Christmas cocktail. We'll be doing this all day here. Christmas and Hollis Queens by Run DMC on WMMS.
MMS. Go changing.
All right. Segment two. Actually, not bad.
No, you stir like around a little bit. Around a little bit. Yeah, it'll come out.
Rob, you want one?
This would be the kind of music you listen to when you're in a fancy restaurant with your girl.
What?
At least you didn't spill it all over yourself.
No, it's all over me, but it's not. It's not on the ground. Snitz, remember we always talk about the time that you puked all over your dick.
Yeah. No, I've never heard that story.
You didn't ever hear that? This is what it looked like. Do you see?
No, I can't.
Okay.
Okay.
When you puked all over your penis and your testicles. That's what it looked like exactly.
Nice.
All right, it was pretty cool. All right.
Wish I was there.
Yeah, I wish you were too. Here, grab one of my exploded beers before. Oh, all right, cool. Are we going to do one more segment here? Yes, we'll just do one more quick one, and then just kind of, we'll see here, right? All right, ready, Snitz?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1. Hold on, don't do yet. By the way, we only have one music bed, so this is what we're this is what we have.
This is what we're stuck with.
I can't find any other one, so, all right. So deal with that. All right, 3, 2, 1. Okay, we're back on the Christmas Craptacular. I'm your host, Charlie, here. I'm sitting here with Jeffrey, and of course, we've got Snitzer working the video room. The whole show, if you want, enjoy it. If the audio thing isn't good enough, go ahead. It's on RMG Plus right now, right, Jeffrey?
Yep.
What are you doing for your Christmas tree? Have you got it yet? It's Christmas Eve.
We got one of those little tabletop trees.
Oh, you did? Is this the one you've always had?
No, it's a little bit different one, and we kind of improvised the decorations a little bit.
What? You know,
because of our living situation.
Oh, so. I did pick you up today, and I don't have the picture available to me right now, but I noticed some interesting Christmas lights on this house. Are those professionally done?
No, those are my son did those.
It's very interesting. They're just kind of, how would you describe it? Krista. They were just kind of dangling off the off the gutter. Yeah, just there's.
Yeah, and then one's wrapped around the tree.
But
the
one's
best.
Wrapped around the tree, but there's no extension cord being used. It's just another string of lights on the ground. So it's just lights on the ground leading up to the house, then off of the gutter into a bush. It's quite a look out there. And I think I saw an Easter bunny in the window. Is that a Christmas bunny?
No, it's not a Christmas bunny. I think it's the thing that was always there even before we got.
So you don't know. Okay, so that's not part
of
it.
I really don't know. But no, he's trying to make the house look festive for Christmas.
Okay,
cut him a break, though.
I like it.
Well, I think it looks great. It's beautiful. It really put me in the Christmas spirit when I went to pick you up. Are you done with your shopping? Did you get the stuff for the kids and everything?
I still got to get the stuff for the shopping.
What are you going to get them?
I don't want to spoil the surprise just in case they might listen.
I don't think they do.
But I found a keyboard.
That's nice.
It has all 88 keys, like a piano.
Oh,
like a
that's awesome.
Piano.
Sweet.
And
For
my son. And I'm going to give them both also a pair of nice corded headphones. My daughter.
Well, you got to get headphones. That's an every year thing, right?
No, yeah. With my daughter,
jeans
she has.
And headphones.
No, my daughter has cordless headphones and she's paired to her phone, but it's a hassle to pair it to both her phone and her laptop. So I'm going to get her the corded headphones she can use in her laptop.
Oh, okay. All right. So she's getting she's getting headphones again?
Well, I got her headphones last year. These are the cordless kind.
Jeffrey, you got her headphones last 10 years in a row.
Yeah, it's every year.
It's every year. But she uses them a lot, so whatever, if that's what you want.
She uses them a lot, but the cordless headphones she's using for her phone and the corded headphones she's going to use for her laptop.
All right. We got more songs to hit, you know?
Yeah.
We got to get some more tunes in on this Christmas craptacular.
Let's get some rocking tunes.
We got up next wait, what's that?
Boo.
Oh, interesting.
Boo.
I don't know what that is. All right,
we'll find out
that is soon enough.
Boo.
Oh, that's
a combination of ghosts and jingle bells.
Huh, I wonder what that could be. All right, well, up next on WMMS is Merry Christmas by Chuck Berry, I think. Here it is. Oh, these lights.
They're getting a great behind the scenes. This is fun.
Is this fun for anybody to see this?
I think they're gonna love it. Yeah.
Okay.
I think they'll get a kick out of it.
So up next, we have how many have we done? Are you three? I've never been allowed to do a music show. Have you ever?
No. I did one with the old studio. Java Joe and I, we did one as an April Fool's joke.
Yeah,
I voice tracked.
Jeffrey, you worked here 12 years. I've been here since 2004. I've never once been allowed to do a show, ever, a music show. But Rob comes in. He sees our bright future, even though you're 53. I'm about to be 40 eventually soon. And he finally, he's given us some chances here. That's pretty cool. All right. So let's come back. All right, play our music here. That's not it. Did I turn it down? There it is. Okay. Nope. Oh, there it is. Sorry. And all right, we're back on the Christmas Craptacular. Thanks so much for tuning in. It's been wonderful spending the holidays with you guys, you know. I couldn't think of a better group of people. My two best friends, Jeffrey and Snitzer, all right?
That's so sweet. Thank you.
Hey, thank you, guys.
Oh, yeah, thank you, Jeffrey.
Thank you. He didn't say that to you.
Oh.
He definitely didn't say it to you, but I said it to you guys, all right? So it's very nice of me
spreading the cheer. Yeah, sitting here, I'm shooting a yid, spinning some Christmas tunes, you know. Why not?
Yeah, no, it's been fun. What this noise again?
Ooh.
What do you think that is, Jeffrey?
Boom.
Sounds like either someone trying to be a ghost and use the jingle bells trying to scare us. We don't know.
I think it's the ghost of Christmas past. Is there anybody you've angered recently that wants to show up?
No. Oh, no!
Oh, yeah!
Jeffrey!
Oh, yeah! Merry Christmas!
Macho Man Randy Savage is back from the dead. He's your ghost of Christmas past?
I didn't see a chimney, so I figured I'd just take the front door. How you doing there, Jeffrey? You dropping some Yule logs?
No, I've been dropping some stunners in a minute.
Oh!
Does this microphone get any higher?
I don't know.
Should I just kneel? Well, Jeffrey, or should I say Ace Maverick? If you remember the last time we interacted, you broke my ribs, took my belt,
Yeah, I still have your belt, too, and it's mine.
Well, I'm here to let you know that Macho Madness is the gift that keeps on giving. And I got a little gift for you right here.
What do you have?
Is that right?
You want to see what's inside this gift?
Oh, what? Let's see.
You want to come over here and open this gift?
Yeah, go over there and see. Open this gift. What could
I got a present just for you. Let's bury the old hatchet, buddy boy.
Right, what could be in this?
What treasures could lie within the box?
What would Macho Man?
Oh, it's my fist! I'm coming for you, buddy boy.
Oh, my
God. Don't you ever forget the spirit of Christmas lives within me, not you. Ho, 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 yeah.
Jeffrey's giving the middle finger. All right, we got some more tunes. Thank you for stopping by, Macho Man. Wow. God. Can you believe that ghost?
What the fuck ever, dude?
What? That's what you have to say to him? He just embarrassed you in your home. This is your home ring.
Well, whatever. I mean, I couldn't put my hands on him, so I had to keep my cool, though.
Okay, you didn't want to break his ribs again?
No. I don't think I want to put him in Mount Sinai Medical Center right now. I could have.
Yeah, last time you interacted with him, I believe you, I don't know if that means you're a bad wrestler or a really good wrestler, but you really hurt him and beat the shit out of him and I think broke his ribs. Does that mean you're a good wrestler or a bad wrestler?
Depends.
What do you think? I thought it's supposed to, you know, you're supposed to kind of fake it a bit, but you were full on just pounding the crap out of him, and it really hurt him.
Hey,
that's why we haven't seen him for a while.
What he gets for pissing me off.
Been recuperating.
Oh, yes. All right. Chris, all right, we got some more tunes on our Christmas Craptacular here. Sweet. Up next on WMMS is Christmas Time by the Smashing Pumpkins, I'm going to guess. I'm going to guess the Smashing Pumpkins. Here we go on WMMS. Macho Man's going to sing us a song, all right? Just don't fight him again. He's got to plug into the board and stuff.
And Jeffrey, I was hoping you would accompany me on the trombone for this
song. Oh,
I can't play a trombone, so.
Just play it. We're all going to play an instrument. We're all going to play an instrument.
Oh, yeah, I have a tambourine. Oh, wait, you have bells.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we got bells.
Okay. So I'm going to play the bells. Oh, there we go. What are... Those conveniently roll on your wrist.
Rob, what are these bells? This looks like some sort of Christmas cock ring.
Yeah, what shop did you get those at?
It's like BDSM weird rings. All right, cool.
I can. Or if you have a mic to point at it, we can do that.
Snitch, are you going to come in for this?
I should maybe sit on the couch so I can reach the mic. I had to really get low.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. I didn't think about that.
No, it's all good.
I can't.
Snitch, you can come in for this? Oh. The couch camera's not working?
The camera. It doesn't. I don't see it ever.
Okay, maybe I can.
He's sitting on the chair or no? Is that not a possibility? He can't hear me.
He doesn't have headphones. What if you lower the chair? The couch might not work.
Okay. Yeah, I didn't even try sitting before.
Okay.
That should be fine. I think this will go over the hat.
Yeah, I think that looks great.
You got it? Perfect.
Perfect. All right, good. All right, so I'm going to have to mix this. I'm going to have to do some live mixing here.
Nice. On the ones and twos.
Which mic? So you're going to be singing into Doogie's mic, right? And playing into
this one?
Yeah. Oh, all right. I think that's guest. I'll just turn them all on.
I hope this is being recorded.
This is our RMG Plus special here. Yeah.
See what you pay for? Quality. Gold.
Look, look at the decorations I bought. I spent over $10 on these decorations from an off-brand dollar store. Not even a real dollar store. It's an off-brand one. And we got some tinsel and...
Tens of dollars were spent.
Nice. Rob didn't even offer to chip in. I paid for this out of my own money.
Wow, what a bum.
But yeah, it is. Yes, I Well, since you tell me what needs to be up, because I'm in the room, so I can't mix right. Does everything sound good?
Yeah, I hear. That sounds nice.
We can do a sound check in a sec.
Okay.
I hear whatever you're hearing.
Yeah, but I'm in the room, so I can also hear it, is what I'm saying.
Gotcha.
Close enough.
That sounds good. All right, so I'm on the sleigh bells. You're on the trombone, all right?
Oh, yeah.
Just grab the trombone. Yeah, just having fun.
Is there one mic you don't need? Is that on?
Oh, it might be. Strum. Okay, that one. Perfect. All right. We'll do a sound check with your mic talking.
Check, check, check. I'm talking.
While strumming, though.
Talking while strumming. Oh, yeah, I'm singing.
Oh, yeah, I'm singing in the Macho Man voice.
That sounds good, right?
Singing in the Macho Man voice.
You gotta help Jeffrey put this thing together. Or is he getting it?
Yeah, you're figuring it out.
Wait, it looks like you do know how to play this.
Oh,
you've got a trombone.
He's a natural.
Pass. Yes, you do.
He's a what's that? The like a pool shark. What are those? Hustler.
Maybe tighten it up a little bit more, so it doesn't fly around like that.
Oh, it's a slide trombone. I guess I don't know the difference.
Here, swing that around there.
I was expecting the trumpet.
Trombone.
You hold this and then you tighten it up with this.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, the Macho Man things are getting in the way.
Oh, jeez.
Oh. All right, that should be good. And then there's a in that little compartment. There's a mouthpiece.
Love this. Oh, this is great. Is it rusty?
So you do like
you do spit, Jeff. You gotta go.
I told you I can't.
No, you don't blow like that. You go. You have to make that noise.
Yeah.
Yes.
There you go.
Oh, sweet.
All right, so we got it. All right, so ready. We're gonna come back from break now. You're in your position. You're in yours. Snitz, ready? Yeah?
Yep.
All right. We don't have this up again. Keep forgetting. All right. Okay, Christmas Craptacular continues. Macho Man was here, almost killed Jeffrey, but Jeffrey scared him off. But they've seemed to make amends because Macho Man has now returned with an acoustic guitar.
I didn't feel good about how that went down, and I wanted to smooth things over.
All right, so I think he's going to play a song here for us, and I got some sleigh bells here. This is great. And Jeffrey on the trombone. This is going to be perfect. All right. So here it is. Macho Man, I guess a song that you said relates to Jeffrey in some way.
This is a Christmas song to hopefully smooth things over with Jeffrey and Ace Maverick.
I would love to see you guys, smooth things over. That's
possible
great.
Future tag team champions.
Right. Yes, I'd love to see the Ace Maverick and the ghost of Randy Savage do it. All right, and whenever, take it away whenever you want, Macho Man. Jerry, hold on. All right, let's restart, okay? Okay. Jeffrey, hold on. Hold on. Don't play the trombone yet. There'll be a part.
I'll tell you when to play the trombone solo.
Macho Man's losing his voice over there.
Sorry. I forgot to bring water.
All right, whenever you're ready, hold on, Jeffrey, until Macho Man clues you in, okay? All right, he'll tell you.
When I say trombone solo, you hit that trombone solo.
Yeah, sure.
Want to practice? Trombone solo.
You got to be quicker.
Perfect. Yes.
That sounds perfect. All right. And a one, a two, one, two, three.
Grandma got suplexed by a wrestler. Watching pay-per-view on Christmas Eve.
Wow.
You could say it's fake professional wrestling, but as for me and Jeffrey, we believe.
Yeah.
She'd been snapping into Slim Jims. As I climbed on the top rope, she caught a whiff of Macho Madness as I flattened her with a flying elbow. When they found her Christmas morning at the scene of the attack, she had boot prints on her forehead. and a steel chair still smashed against her back. Grandma got suplexed by a wrestler. Oh yeah, watching pay-per-views on Christmas Eve. Oh yeah, you could say it's fake professional wrestling. Oh yeah, but as for me and Jeffrey, we believe trombone solo, yeah. Grandma got suplexed by a wrestler, watching pay-per-views on Christmas Eve. Hit me with some more trombone. You could say it's fake professional wrestling, but as for me and Jeffrey, we believe trombone. As for me and Jeffrey, we believe.
Wow! That's a once-in-a-lifetime performance from the ghost of Macho Man Randy Savage. Jeffrey.
Yeah, now he just needs to take some more stuff to cure his laryngitis.
Oh, you're way. You're not. That didn't smooth things over?
Maybe you ought to take some trombone lessons. I thought you had some experience playing the rusty variety.
No. I told you I couldn't play this damn thing if I tried.
You son of a bitch.
He's trying to smooth things
you
over.
Son of a bitch. I wrote a song for you.
It's Christmas. Come on.
Christmas cheer,
Macho Man.
Seriously. He doesn't drink.
Yeah, you don't drink? Oh, I forgot.
Jesus.
I'm a recovering alcoholic.
Oh, man, that's heavy.
Jeez.
Dude. Hey, hang in there. Merry Christmas.
I better get
Macho
out of
man.
Here. This is not a healthy environment for me.
All right, Macho Man, I'm
all
sorry.
Right, hey, man.
I thought it was really nice.
Regardless, Merry Christmas, Macho Man. Have a good one, buddy.
Would you like the lyrics better if instead of a grandma got suplexed by a wrestler, it was.
I actually like
grandma
that.
Got.
Honestly, I like the whole song. Let me go help him pack up his wrestling grandma
got,
here.
Grandma got fucked by Jeffrey LaRoe. Would that be a better song?
All right. I can't do that with a broken unit.
Okay. All right. It's just the beginning of the Christmas Craptacular. We have more in store. So thank you for sticking around here. If you wanted to see that, we are doing this on RMG Plus right now. Up next, we got Pearl Jam. Pearl Jam Christmas song.
They have one?
I guess so. Can't
awesome.
Wait. I can't wait to hear it. All right. That's coming up next on 100.7 WMMS.
let me sleep.
That's a Christmas song?
Yes.
Okay. It's a bummer?
No. Oh.
You can just leave it. We'll clean it up.
Jeffrey, we don't have to. Yeah, don't worry about that right now.
I'm going to get changed. You guys have some breaks to do without me, right?
Yeah, so we're going to do some stuff. Then
you get to introduce yourself for 100.7. I don't think you've ever said, hey, it's Charlie.
Yeah, we can get some of those.
I don't know. Again, I'm not used to doing a music show.
That's why I'm telling you now.
Well, thank you.
We could definitely get some things from you guys, just saying.
Okay.
Because I wrote a bunch of imaging, too, remember?
Oh, all right. Oh, I forgot that was in there. Okay.
So some of that stuff I'll use into that bed, and we'll make it all match.
It's behind the scenes. It's gold.
Oh, this is good stuff. Yeah. Oh, no. Stuff. Christmas or Snitzers. I just called you.
I'm Christmas.
No, he's just going. All right. So if Macho Man comes in and fucks around, Macho Man's song, Macho Man leaves. All right. So we're right on track here.
You got two more, right, before the next guest?
Yeah. All right. All right. Ready? I keep hitting the wrong thing. Here we go. Ready, Snitz?
Yeah.
Welcome back to the Christmas Craptacular. My name's Charlie. I'm usually doing the sound effects for Rover's Morning Glory. I'm sitting here with Jeffrey. Jeffrey, what is your title on the show?
I'm just Knucklehead.
Knucklehead.
Pretty much.
We got the Knucklehead here. And, of course, Anthony Snitzer doing video because we are filming this, too.
Amen.
We got some great behind-the-scenes footage going on. If you want to see how this was created, this Christmas Craptacular. Macho Man was just in. Wonderful. Did you like his gift that he gave you, his fist?
Well, he could have given me something else besides a fist, but...
What could he have given you?
Jeez.
Maybe, I don't know.
Family show.
What do you want? A fisting?
No. It was an interesting surprise.
Were you impressed?
I was impressed with the song, yeah, but not with him putting a fist in my face.
Well, I don't think he actually punched you, did he?
No, he did not. So okay. I'll give him that one song.
All right.
Anyways,
so
it was just trying to smooth things over, but I didn't realize he was a recovering alcoholic. So I wanted to, you know, give him a beer and
it's all right.
He's beers in a bucket. You know what?
You know. All right. What was your favorite Christmas memory, Jeffrey? Like, what's your best gift you ever got?
Me personally,
yeah, you.
I'm trying to think. I got a lot of cool stuff for Christmas over the, you know, when I was a kid.
Name one.
The Star Wars Millennium Falcon.
Ooh. So how big was this? Because I know they have, like, I don't know, which version or whatever. Tell me about
it. It's the one where the part of it comes off so you can see the interior of it and everything okay. like that. And they have one where you can open the cockpit, you know, put the two figures in there. Yeah, it was really cool.
That's sweet. Snitz, yours?
I mean, maybe, like, I don't know if you remember Sock 'em Boppers.
Yeah,
the
kind of trash toy.
Yeah, but my grandpa got them for me, and there's a picture of us together, and he hasn't been around for a long time, and just like I, you know, have fond memories of that.
What
us,
a bummer!
Like, us punching each other.
What a bummer answer.
No, it's fond memory.
Wait, this is the little game.
No. That's Rock 'em Sock 'em Robots.
Oh, this is actually
this
you
is
guys
Sock 'em Boppers. You put at these blow up.
This is your
gloves.
Grandpa used to abuse you.
He used to abuse me. Yeah, I didn't want to go for that far, but yeah.
No, that's fun. I guess that's pretty cool. Yeah. My dad never got me boxing gloves and then punched me in the face. That sounds great.
It's a different era.
Yeah. My favorite toy was this, Jeffrey, you'll like this, F-14 Tomcat. Man, in the commercial, it was flying around this kid's room.
Uh-huh.
And it looked sweet
was
as hell.
Was it radio controlled?
Well, when I got it, it turns out it doesn't actually fly. It just kind of lifts off and makes noises.
Oh.
And just, that was it. That was kind of cool. What's your worst gift?
I don't know, I can't think of any. I don't think I really ever recall I ever got any bad gifts.
You never got a bad gift?
No, not really, you know. That I can recall. What I could recall.
Are you okay? You're choking up?
Yeah, well, no, I'm just like, just got no. I have to take some. I brought some Ricolas with me.
What? What's
got
going on?
Oh, got a sore throat.
You're sick?
Mm-mm. Right before the holiday, we're all going to see family.
What do you mean? You're not sick, but you have a sore throat and you're going to take a Ricola.
Well, I took one already, so I'm good.
Oh, okay, that cures it.
Oh, that cures it, right?
Well, no, it's just like it's, it came on yesterday, so I started taking ease and some cough medicine to nip it in the bud so that it doesn't fester and get worse.
So the gift you're giving me for Christmas is strep throat.
No, I'm not giving you strep
that's,
throat.
Thank
gift
you.
Gift that keeps on giving.
Yes, I'm going to give that to my
Snitz.
Whole family.
What the hell ever, dude?
Snitz, what's your worst gift?
A bag of coal. I was a bad kid sometimes, and I actually got a bag of coal.
I didn't know anybody ever did that.
I know. It was horrible.
One of my weirdest, I'm not going to say worst, weirdest gifts was just like a blue grocery bag filled with CDs, burned CDs that my uncle said he found at the front of his driveway. And it was just old, who was it? He used to go by Titty Boy. Who's that? I'm sure you know that, Rob. Titty Boy. Anyways.
E-40?
Just, no, it's not E-40. No, he's popular now. He just changed his name and now he's actually popular. It's not Future, but anyways, it's just a bag of burned CDs that he had just found on the ground, and that was the gift I got. He says, you like rap, I think, and I think this is rap. They weren't even the real CDs, all burned and just all scratched, and I got a bag of those. That was fun, you know, all gathering around listening to a little Titty Boy. All right, we're going to keep things moving along here. Up next on the Christmas Craptacular, we've got The Kinks, one of my favorite Christmas songs.
Ooh, yes.
You know what song it is, Jeffrey?
No, okay, I'll listen to The Kinks.
We're doing a rock Christmas show. You don't know Father Christmas?
No.
Well, here it is. Open your ears and listen, okay? Here it is. The Kinks.
Yeah, sure.
Father Christmas on 100.7 WMMS.
Nice abrupt music.
Well, I forgot. He's got a... Cool.
All right. We're back.
Two Chainz.
Oh.
What's Two Chainz? Yep.
You've been Chromebooked.
They just Chromebooked their ass.
Yeah.
All right. Up next. Huh?
Two more.
Well, up next, we're just going to have Miles come back in.
And then it's the one after that, correct?
Yep.
Okay.
Is Miles prepping him with stuff? And okay, cool. All right. But tell Miles he's about to come in. All right. Are we ready?
Yeah.
The gift I have for Jeffrey yet?
No, we're going to do that later.
Okay.
Hello and welcome to the Christmas Craptacular. I'm your host, Charlie. I usually do sound effects on a WMMS there for Rover's Morning Glory. I'm here with Jeffrey LaRocque and, of course, Anthony Snitzer. Having a blast here hanging out with you for these holidays. Really just really loving to spend time together with you.
Yeah, thanks
for
having me.
Is that right?
Yeah. What are you doing for Christmas? Are you coming over? I invited you.
I'm going to my parents' house first. They're doing something for Christmas, too.
What time?
Probably like early in the afternoon. And if it's, like I said, if it's not, like I said, when we're done, I'll give you a holler and say, look, Charlie, we're on our way over.
My parents will love you if you came because they love having you over. So, I don't know.
Yeah, your parents are pretty cool.
Pretty cool?
Yeah. Oh.
You said you were about to say you love them. They love you too. Aww. So it's all right.
No, I'm just saying they're pretty cool. You know, they're fun to hang around.
All right, we got another special guest coming in right now, Jeffrey. Do you have any guesses of who it could be?
I have no clue.
Has he ticked off anybody else?
Yeah. Who is it? It's Miles,
the man himself,
or Taint Smasher.
Yep.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Merry Christmas.
You just missed it. Macho Man was just in here.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
Man, I love that guy.
Yeah, he's actually.
Is that the guy who's like, oh yeah?
He kind of sounds like that. Yeah.
Yeah. Cool.
He says you were a dork and a pussy when he left.
Oh man,
that was pretty messed up.
Well,
but
that sucks. I look up to that guy.
Hey, if you want, I'll teach you. If he calls you that to your face, I can teach you how to drop a stunner on him.
Oh yeah.
If Miles meets Macho Man, you're gonna teach him how to do a stunner.
Teach him about how to give Macho Man a stunner. Next time Macho Man insults him.
Yeah, let's do that. Do you have time this weekend?
I don't know what I'm doing this weekend.
Well, it's Christmas.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm just gonna stay home and just chill.
No, you just said you're lying. You just said you're coming to my house.
Oh, I'm visiting my parents first. And then coming to your house.
Well, what do you do in New Year's? You guys get together in New Year's.
I haven't planned New Year's yet.
What are you thinking?
I don't know.
All right,
just come over to my house before you go to your mom's.
Yeah, he's in Akron.
You live in Akron now?
Yeah, it's only like an hour and a half away.
Oh yeah. Okay, I'll take that under advisement.
All right, so Miles/Taint Smasher is going to be here for the rest of the Christmas Craptacular. Thank you for swinging by.
Hey, thanks for having me.
Beautiful outfit. I like that you actually dressed up for the occasion.
Of course. King Diamond Snowman or whatever.
Yeah, exactly.
is that what that is?
Like a Norwegian black metal snowman.
<Love it.
laughs> That's great. All right, well, we got more rockin' Christmas songs. You want to rock out, Miles?
Always.
All right, up next, we got the Killers, you know. They rock.
Hell yeah. They alternative rock.
Yes. All right. We got the Killers, A Great Big Sled on 100.7 WMMS. Ooh, I like the name of that one. Next one's good.
Good enough. You're
dipping in?
No. What's your next guest?
Oh, all right. Oh, okay. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know what the next guest is doing. Do you got a plan?
Who, me?
Yeah. Did you talk to him?
Oh, yeah.
You've talked to him?
Yeah.
I don't know what we're doing.
Yeah, he's giving presents out.
Okay. And... Well, I know that much.
Here?
Huh?
Here?
Or where? All right, perfect.
I showed him what the things are.
Oh, he's down? All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
What do you just want to do from here?
Probably that one. Well, actually, Snitzer, you tell us.
We have a shot.
Snitz, what do you think?
Yeah,
it's just that one is so small.
Like this one?
That works if you're staying right there.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
I'll do that.
All right, keeping...
This one?
Yes, that's fine. Yeah, cool. All right, so that one doesn't work, Snitz? Oh, you're saying that one doesn't move right now, right?
Which one?
The couch one?
That...
Because you also have
way over there? That one?
Yeah, would that work for Santa? Or no, I guess I'm in the way then.
Yeah, that one...
I just said
horrible.
Who the guest was. Damn it.
Oh.
All right. Okay, here we go. We're ready? I think we're fine. All right. We'll figure it out. Welcome back to the Christmas Craptacular. I'm your host, Charlie. I'm sitting here with Taint Smasher.
Hey, Merry Christmas.
We had Macho Man earlier. We got Jeffrey LaRocque here.
Yo, what's up?
And
Merry Christmas, everybody.
We have Snitzer in the video room, but let's not forget the reason for the season. What is that, Jeffrey?
It's Christmas.
Well, what's the reason for the season, though?
My understanding is that Jesus Christ is born.
You're talking religious one. Yeah, I'm not talking that. I'm talking about the more fun one.
Oh, you mean like everyone gets together and they drink, have a good time, give each other gifts, stuff like that?
Oh, the real one. The big man. I think we got the big man outside.
Oh, yeah. Old St. Nicholas.
Oh, we got old St.
Nicholas himself.
Yeah, let's see who we got coming in here. Here we go. Look at this.
Oh, Santa.
Wow.
Merry Christmas, boys.
You talking to that microphone.
Yo, Merry Christmas.
Hey. I was just flying over North Canton, and I heard you boys were in here.
Oh yeah.
I didn't know your sleigh had Wi-Fi where you could pick up the radio station,
dude.
Going high tech this year, huh?
Everything.
Wait, the couches are on. Hold on.
Okay.
There we go.
Talk. Ho, 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 ho,
can you hear it? Can you hear him?
Yeah, but I'm in the room.
Oh yeah. Oh, you got him. All right. What's up,
hey,
Santa?
Hey, Santa Claus.
Oh, you guys bring Santa a beer?
Oh yeah. You want to kick back?
Yeah.
Have a few.
I'm not driving. The reindeer are.
Oh hell yeah.
Yeah.
You want a shotgun one, Santa?
Rudolph
guiding your sleigh tonight.
Yeah, he doesn't. He's not driving.
What's that, Jeffrey?
Rudolph guiding your sleigh tonight.
Always.
All right.
He's always.
You got some keys for him to shotgun?
Oh wow. Okay.
Oh, you got an angry one.
I dropped those 45 minutes.
It's easier to chug it in the summer when my beard hasn't fully come
in. Yeah,
yet.
It's great.
It's a little more difficult. We should maybe get to the presents.
You don't want to keep drinking, Santa?
Well, I don't want to, puke on any little kids again.
Okay.
I mean, presents. I like the sound of that.
Presents sound wonderful.
I brought gifts for all you gentlemen.
Let's see what he's got here.
But first, have we been good boys this year?
I've been great. I've been awesome.
Are you really vaping while you're telling me you've been a good boy this year?
I quit smoking, so that's one thing.
Okay.
That's kind of good, right?
Okay, has anyone punched any little kids this year?
No, I don't think so.
Not this year.
Has everyone kept their pants on in public this year?
I know. Well, LaRoque.
Yeah, I've kept my pants on.
Okay.
Oh, come on. There's been plenty of times.
Not this year, though.
Okay, not this year. All right, not this year. Yeah, he's much better.
Did you follow me down a chimney to someone's house?
Yes.
No.
You're very filthy today. Jeffrey, you've never been.
He does look like he came down a chimney.
You look like Oliver Twist or whoever the chimney sweep is or whatever.
I did bring some porridge. All right. Santa's got some gifts here.
Okay, what do we got?
Here's one for Charlie. Should we pass them all out first?
Sure.
Okay, yeah, we'll pass them out first. I'll wait. All right.
Be polite, Charlie. Jeez. Yeah,
geez,
this one's for Snitz.
Okay. Right. Snitz has one.
Can we get it delivered over to him?
I can take it to him.
Okay.
What else we got here, Santa?
Santa,
how's Mrs. Claus?
Oh, she's fantastic.
You ever motorboat those knockers?
Ever?
Yeah.
Every night.
Wow.
There you go.
That's what keeps the sleigh going.
It's not the spirit of Christmas. It's how much you can motorboat.
Indeed.
Your wife's big Hooters.
I fill up a tank underneath the sleigh.
With your wife's Hooter juice.
Yeah,
wow.
Speaking of taints.
Oh, hey.
Thanks,
Santa. You didn't have to do that.
Will you pass that over to Jeffrey for me?
My present smells like alcohol.
Don't know where that came from. Now, my elves work very hard on these gifts.
Okay. I'm excited to see.
We checked your lists, your emails.
You're opening first, Jeffrey?
Oh, all right.
Yeah, go ahead.
What do you got?
What you got there? Wow. Is that a jar of weed?
No way.
Santa, where did you come? Oh, he did say he came from North Canton.
Those are some dank nugs.
Now, your list did say you had your card, Jeffrey.
That doesn't look like it came from a dispensary, though.
No, that looks homegrown.
That's homegrown.
Oh, my God.
That's a lot.
Let me smell how dank these are. The elves make this?
Yeah, Santa's rules. No seeds, no stones, no sticks.
Wow, that's some good stuff.
I got to tell you, at this point in my life, I don't think I would smoke weed if it came out of a bag. I'm a jar weed only.
Really? You're that sophisticated.
Yeah, I think so.
You're no longer a trash person.
I'm in my 40s, man. I don't have time for bag weed.
If you do smoke, you think you're not a trash person. You think you're elevated. And you know what? I'd say that puts him on the naughty list. He's singing this kind of ego.
Should I not open my gift?
We'll see.
Okay.
We'll see.
Well, okay, this kind of reminds me of my recent Christmas. We have Sex Jams 2003, Party Mix 2005, and then they're all like crossed out here. And then Sex Jams again 2010, and then Breakup Songs 2020.
Oh, man. That's like a whole story of a relationship.
That's great. What else? And just pubes?
Oh, some pubes.
Oh, great. Some elf pubes.
Everyone needs a good merkin, guys.
Santa, it's been a rough year for Santa. Inflation's hitting him hard.
Oh, it's hitting me really hard. That right. costs $3,500.
Let's see what we got in here.
Man, you listen.
I got a knife. this is a big knife.
That's a pretty.
You know what?
Is it legal to have a knife this big? Don't they need to be like less than the width of your palm?
I think you're kind of right, and I think that's technically a sword. And how many bodies does that have on it?
62.
Wow.
So, I feel like.
And now your prints are on that. So
well, we are downtown.
Oh, great!
Now.
My fingerprints are all over this now.
Well, Santa better go.
Is this the real Santa? Where did you find this guy?
We just saw a guy walking down the street earlier.
I was getting some Zanzibar.
And he was high
with
on Xanax. He was high on Xanax at Zanzibar, and we just asked him to come in.
All right, it's starting to add up.
Snitz, what did you get?
Oh, yeah, I got to get mine. Okay, open this up here. It's a little
cookie tin thing.
Cookie tin. And then it's like a card in there. Oh, nice. Oh, well, that's sweet. I got the death card.
Santa, what is going on?
I go by the list, guys. Jeez.
This is dark.
Yeah. This is pretty fucked. Well,
this is the darkest Christmas ever.
Yeah. All right, Santa, get the fuck out of here.
Santa, get the fuck out of here.
Can I get the jar of weed? Can I get the jar of weed?
Wait. I just had a great idea.
Yeah.
Grab one of those beers.
Yeah.
Use this to poke a hole in it and shotgun it.
Yes, you gotta do that or we're calling the cops.
We're calling the cops. All right, I'll do it.
Oh, this is sweet. All right, Santa.
Oh, jeez.
You know how to shotgun, right?
I'm more into fisticuffs.
I can tell this guy has shotgunned a couple beers before.
Oh, boy.
This thing's going to pop. There we go. Oh, this is
a fun list. Oh, put your mouth on it. Yeah, there we go. Crack it.
I don't think he came with his gloves.
There you go.
There we go.
Santa!
Chug, 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 chug,
chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug,
chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug,
chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug,
chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug,
chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug,
chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, you're listening to 100.7 WMS, and we're doing this live on, or not live, recorded on RMG Plus, so check it out if you want at roverradio.com. But we got to get some more tunes in, right?
Oh, yeah. That's what we're here for. We got to get some tunes in.
Any requests?
Oh, yeah, Last Christmas by Wham?
We don't. This is the rockin' Christmas
version.
Oh,
yeah, my bad.
Except,
I don't know.
Except we're about to go to a rap song, but it's a good one. We got Curtis Blow, Christmas Rappin' on 100.7 WMMS.
Nice.
That shotgun really fucking
really
brought it all together.
I think you got to give that weed back.
Oh yeah. Wow. I'm not gonna get pop.
I'll make sure Santa gets this back.
Yeah, I'm not getting pop for possession of weed.
You're gonna make sure you're putting in your car and stuff and make sure Santa gets it.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
I live near where he came from. Yeah.
Nice.
All right.
This behind the scenes is. Still gold. Platinum, I think, even.
Well, let's see. I gotta see what's next here. Oh.
Are we cussing? I think you cussed during that break.
Yeah. Rob has to edit it out.
Oh, so we just create work for him every time we cuss?
Yeah. But right now we can because we're actually not doing this. It's just RMG Plus, so we could say whatever ones you want.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, you could say that. But no, if you say it when we're doing the segments, Rob will have to edit it out.
Oh,
but
gotcha.
It felt like I didn't have enough power if I said get the hell out. Here's Santa's back. Santa, by the way. Yeah, but it's behind the scenes. Santa, by the way, is Jeremiah from, what is it? Kiss. Sorry, I almost said the old station.
Well.
No, sorry. All right, Jeremiah from Kiss, you did a wonderful Santa.
Thank you.
Thank you for the beautiful gifts.
Thank you. Of course, yeah. Wherever. Juicy nugs.
And you made quite a mess. So I'll just tell Rover that you did it once it's all sticky when
Santa
we come back.
Did it.
Yeah.
Great job pounding two beers in 1 second, though. That was nice.
And I'm on a diet.
God. Not anymore.
Nope.
Thank you, Santa. All right. So we're coming back. Rob, you're cleaning. Thank you. No, thank you so much. That was great. All right. Actually, you know, I'm really liking my Christmas cocktail I made. Do you like it?
Yeah, I like it.
What you got?
Well, I just put cinnamon and nutmeg in a High Life.
Oh, all right. That's Why festive.
Not? You know, it's festive. Yeah. And I got a cinnamon stick in there. All right, up next.
Dear Christ.
What?
Oh, no.
Was it a mess?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
No.
Don't worry about it.
That spraying beer everywhere, I'm sure, was
There's a part in our script thing coming up that I didn't write anything. I didn't look up for the 8:30. It's the one that says 8:30. I didn't look up, so. So we can just.
Christmas trivia. Oh, you don't have any trivia?
I don't have any.
Here, let's Google it.
Yeah, just Google it. So Google that. We'll get to that in a second.
Do you want to do like, how do you want to do trivia? I can ask the questions if you want.
Yeah, that's fine. I like the second part in there. I don't want to say what the second part is. What do you think?
Nice. Damn.
Do you see the second sentence in there?
Oh, okay.
That's just an idea.
This year, I'm not gonna do that.
Well, yeah, I know you're not. Me and Jeffrey will.
I hear that.
Oh, yeah.
I know. I'm preparing something.
Why didn't you do
it? This behind the scenes is great, right, Snitz?
Oh, it's fantastic. It's the best thing I've ever seen in my life.
All right. I want to tell you a story. YouTube has two ads now? I used to believe that.
Three?
I get three sometimes.
Really?
Yeah.
Jeez.
Okay. All right. We're all ready?
Yep.
Oh, you might have to be able to. Can you? What screen can you see, Snitz?
The one your video's on?
You can?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. All right. And let's go. 3, 2.
Three, two,
one. It's the Christmas Craptacular! I'm Charlie, the sound effects guy for Rover's Morning Glory. I'm sitting here with Jeffrey, of course.
Yo, what's happening?
We're doing a special Christmas show because we weren't allowed to do one on the oldie station.
Gigi got lucky.
Yeah, she said, they just said no to us. And I got a Snitzer here and, of course, Taint Smasher.
Hey,
so we're
thanks
all
for
here.
Having me.
No, guys, after I was denied, I was so upset. I said, I got to put together a team of experts to make the best goddamn Christmas show possible. So here we are.
So far.
I didn't listen to Doogie's, but I guarantee it's not. Oh. She didn't have Santa Claus as a shotgun and a beer and giving people weed. So
right.
I think so far. All right. Jeffrey, what's your favorite Christmas song?
Oh, well, I don't put a lot of stock into Christmas music nowadays, but if I have to pick a favorite, it would be, like I said, Wham's version of Last Christmas.
It's not what you said in the car, because I asked you this, and I have a song ready. I said, what's your favorite Christmas song?
Oh,
and you said your son's favorite Christmas song is Wham. And
yeah,
you told
that,
me.
And that another one is that the one Paul McCartney does.
You said Paul McCartney. Why do you like this one so much?
Oh, it just has a nice little holiday, I guess, a little reggae sound to it, you know?
All right. And you're a karaoke expert, right?
Yeah, I don't know what I say.
You do it a lot. Get in the Christmas spirit.
Nobody does more karaoke than you.
Ever.
Yeah, but I don't karaoke Christmas music.
Well, do you think you could? For a Christmas?
I've thought about it.
Well, do you think if we're doing maybe a Christmas special on the radio, do you think you might be able to do...
I feel like today's the day.
Yeah, I think if I was to do a Christmas karaoke song, I would do today. Do you think you could?
I'll give it a shot.
All right. So I got Paul McCartney, Wonderful Christmas Time, which you said in the car on the way here.
I've never actually sang this before. I'll give it a the old college try.
All right.
Give
all
me
right.
a hot. So, like.
Where'd you go to college?
Nowhere. I love this intro.
I don't.
Oh, really? I do.
It's because you're a synth guy, Snitz.
Oh, yeah.
The mood is right. The spirit's up. We're here tonight. And that's enough. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. The party's on. The feeling's here. That only comes this time of year. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time.
Well, that's good work, Jeffrey. That was
nice.
Really good.
Nice. Great job.
I think that was good. What's your guys? What's your favorite song? Anybody else talk while I?
I really like. So Death Row Records did a Christmas album once, and it was all like gangster ass Christmas songs. And they did one called "Santa Claus Goes Straight to the Ghetto" with Nate Dogg singing on it.
Oh, okay.
And like, I just went to listen to it today to get in the spirit, and it's not on Spotify anymore. So I don't know if you could pull it on YouTube or something.
I'll try to find it.
But if not, like, I can just sing it for you. He's like, Santa Claus goes straight to the ghetto, and then insert verse.
Okay, that's the song. Yeah, I've never heard that. Okay, I'll try to find that, and then we'll have to have Rob edit it there. So, all right, I'm gonna do a little karaoke here. Let's see. My favorite Christmas song. All right, this really gets me in the spirit.
Oh, nice. This is a hard one to sing.
You think?
Yeah. You're
gotta,
ambitious.
You gotta have pipes.
I don't mean to psych you out. I'm sure you're gonna do fine.
D's nuts sitting on Jeffrey's chin as I pull down his wife's pantyhose. That's actually all I wrote. So
it's a classic.
I was gonna say
that's as far as I got, huh?
I don't have my glasses on. I couldn't read the.
Oh yeah, no, that was the lyrics, okay. I believe, to the actual song.
Splat
so.
King Hole.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Up next, we got Billy Squire. Christmas is the time.
Splat Stink Hole.
Oh yeah, that's way better. We got Billy Squire. Christmas is the time to say I love you on 100.7
WMMS Cleveland.
The Buzzard.
The Buzzard.
On 100.7
WMMS. The Buzzard.
Cleveland.
Billy Squire on
Cleveland.
WMMS.
All right.
The Buzzard.
All right. Okay.
Cleveland.
Okay. All right. So let's come back. Did anybody look up that thing? Did you look up those questions?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, did I say what it was twice and I wasn't supposed to?
What?
Hmm?
Did you say what was?
Nothing.
No, you didn't. Okay. Oh, it doesn't matter. This is a behind-the-scenes action here, all right? So, all right, here we go.
I never know what's a secret and what isn't with you guys. Like, every time I speak, I'm like, oh, shit, did I just say something that's supposed to be secret?
No, this is a full, we're just doing the behind-the-scenes thing so people can see how we put together
like, I don't
this
know
mess.
Who said what to who.
Yeah.
What the hell?
It's fine.
There's Cleveland.
There's no other. I'm trying to think if there's any other secrets. No. No, we got the whole, no, the show's, yeah, we're going fine. All right. All right. Welcome to the Christmas Craptacular. I'm your host, Charlie, here sitting with Jeffrey, Taint Smasher, and Snitz.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas,
everybody.
Happy holidays. I hope everybody's having a blast out there. Thanks for tuning in. If you want to watch us, we're on roverradio.com and on RMG Plus. You can see the special, the great behind the scenes we're doing. If you want to see some of Rob, the program director, cleaning up Santa Claus's mess and just, you know, doing some stuff like that. It's really interesting
stuff. Santa
Claus stuff.
Attempting to shotgun a beer and it gets all over the place.
Well, Yeah, if you want to see that, yeah, of course. Up next, you know, Jeffrey, I know you're a trivia guy. I'm a trivia guy. So
I don't know about that.
I know you're a huge Christmas guy, you're a huge Christmas head guy. I'm big into Christmas. So Taint Smasher's prepared really hard. He's
did
really
a lot of research.
Really hard on some Christmas trivia. And we'll go ahead, you know, fill up your drink halfway.
He's got a can. Do you need a freshie?
No, I'm good right here, dude.
All right, good.
Let's give him an extra one just in case.
I'm good.
We're going to do drunk Christmas trivia. Just here you go, Jeffrey. Put it in the cup. It's not open yet. Be careful because apparently I shook these up 20 minutes ago. And they're still spraying liquid everywhere. All right. So I got mine. All right. If you get it wrong, I don't know the rules. You tell us the rules. We get it wrong, we got to drink half the beer or whatever, right? Half the cup. Is that fine?
Yeah, if you get it wrong, you drink until I say stop.
Okay, that's fine. Like a waterfall thing. Okay, cool.
Yeah, I'll give you like a couple seconds or whatever.
Well,
all right, who's going first?
Just going back and forth? No planning went into this. Are we going back and forth? Like you're just going to ask me a question?
Or do you want to do like Family Feud style where you just yell it out first?
What do you want, Jeffrey?
Let's yell it out.
Yeah, yell it out. Jeffrey's right. Why are you uninterested in our Christmas game?
No, it's because I think you're going to cheat. That's why. We know you're a known cheater.
Oh.
Oh.
He just looked it up.
I literally just Googled Christmas trivia.
Yeah, okay. I know, but I'm competing. I know I'm competing against a known cheater.
If Jeffrey, if you were paying attention in the commercial break or whatever on RMG Plus, which you can go back to, Miles said he was just going to look it up.
Okay.
All right, it's not cheating.
I trust you.
All right. Let's go.
All right. So, question one. Where was baby Jesus born?
Nazareth.
Yeah, I mean, obviously he got it.
Yeah.
Drink.
It's okay. Yeah, I lost.
1,000. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. All right, here we go.
Just 1 second.
I was going to say Bethlehem. Does Bethlehem not count?
They both count. Okay, I think they're both accurate.
Okay, all right.
But you didn't say anything.
Yeah, I didn't say shit.
The movie Miracle on 34th Street is based on a real-life department store. What is it?
Macy's.
Correct. Jeffrey, you got a drink. 1,000. Okay.
All right, we're keeping it easy so far. Okay. Right.
Yeah. See, everybody's drinking for the same amount of time because I'm counting seconds. What are the two other most popular names for Santa Claus?
St. Nick and old Kris Kringle.
Yeah, nicely done. Getting nailed here. 1,000. That you kind of cut it off early there.
Well, I was out of beer.
Yeah.
This is a good pour.
All right, that's good. All right, Elvis isn't going to have a white Christmas. He's going to have...
blue Christmas!
Correct. Jeffrey Drink, 1,000. Nicely done. He gave a little extra. See, he's going the extra mile
there. He is. He's trying. He thinks I'm cheating, so now I like almost want to throw it so that it proves that I'm not cheating. I'm not cheating. He just Googled it. All right.
What do people traditionally put on top of a Christmas tree?
Star. Angel.
Angel is correct. Jeffrey, you got a drink.
I will, you know, I'm going to drink 1,000. On that too.
Okay. Both drinking?
I feel like it's either or.
I feel like it's 50-50.
Yeah, so I'm not going to fault you for that. I would have said star too, but you said
some
it first.
People have preferences as either star or an angel.
What's your preference?
My parents used to put a star on our Christmas tree when I was a kid.
What do you put on yours?
Nothing.
Nothing?
No.
What is it?
Nothing. We don't put a star on our tree, dude.
Do you put anything on it?
The last good tree we had was a fiber optic tree where the ledger was actually built into it.
Oh, yeah.
What year was that?
About 5-6 years ago.
But wait, you said you had a tabletop one this year.
Yeah, it's a little, because the one that we would usually use that we threw that out because of the whole.
Hey, when I'm done with my live tree, I'll give it to you so you can use it for next year.
Oh, I don't need a live tree, dude.
No, but you can just have it.
Yeah, but the thing will just wither
and
die.
I'll just plant it
in his yard after you're done with it.
I'll plant it in your yard, then you have to dig it up every year, okay?
No, thanks, dude. I
think that'll work. All right.
Try. Okay, next question.
Yeah. In Home Alone, where are the McAllisters going on vacation when they leave Kevin behind?
Paris, France.
Ooh, that was a close one. That was a photo finish. I think, okay, say Paris again. 3, 2, 1.
Paris.
Fuck.
Ooh.
Oh, that's a tie. We got to keep moving.
Give me number two. Give me where they went on number. Oh, well, I already know the answer, so that doesn't
help. Well, obviously, you're a Home Alone guy, so yes. Let's just keep it moving.
Okay.
In the classic Christmas movie, How the Grinch. Oh, I thought they were talking about the Christmas movie or a Christmas. How the Grinch Stole Christmas. The Grinch is described with three words. What are they?
Stink, stink, stunk.
Damn.
Stink, stink, stunk.
That's correct.
Whatever, dude.
And 1,000. Okay. Nicely done. In which modern-day country was St. Nicholas born in? That's a hard one.
Ooh. Russia?
Norway.
Both wrong. Drink. It's Turkey. 1,000.
What?
Really?
I don't know. I'll drink. He's from North Pole.
No, St. Nicholas.
Oh, the guy.
Yeah, the guy. Like.
After
he was canonized, did they, like, send him up to the North Pole to live for the rest of his life? Like, when he became a saint?
You don't get canonized when you're alive.
It's 5 years after your death.
You got to be dead to be canonized.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's got to be 5 years after your death.
I thought they did Mother Teresa before she died.
No, she was just buried, but I think she was canonized 5 years after she died.
After St. Nicholas.
I would love to be canonized after I die. Literally, like, shot out of a cannon.
No, but I think after St. Nick died, they just flew him up to North Pole and just kind of dropped him off.
Okay, so hang on a sec. You know, do you know they have bones of saints at the Cleveland Art Museum? Like, if you, like anywhere in the museum where you see the word relic, that means it has a bone of a saint in it.
I didn't know that.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, there's one. There's one. It's like a sculpture. It's like a bronze sculpture of a hand that looks like this, and it's like a whole ass arm bone in there, dude.
Oh, sweet. Jeffrey, would you want any body part in there?
No.
Your boner? I got him. All right. All right. We got any more?
What words follow Silent Night in the song?
Oh, Holy Night.
Yep, that's correct. Jeffrey, drink. 1,000. He's trying to get turned.
No, he is. We're getting that. That's why we got a ride.
Oh, okay.
We have a ride.
All right, great.
Ride here and a ride home. We're
all right,
set.
Well, let's up the ante. Let's do 5 second chugs.
Okay, let's go.
All right. Which Hollywood actor played 6 different roles in The Polar Express?
Tom Hanks.
Correct. Oh, Jeffrey, man. Drink. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, 1,000.
That's
now
like a
talking.
Kids movie, so you'd only know it if you have kids. Do you know it?
I only saw it once.
Oh, you did see it, though?
Yeah, I have it on video.
Did you take your kids to it?
No, I rented I have the DVD at home.
All right.
Which country did eggnog come from? Let's take a guess.
That's got to be Eastern Ukraine or something. That's, I don't know. Whatever my girlfriend lives, they kind of gross food from over there. Where are you from? Czech Republic.
Czech Republic is your answer? Well, that's incorrect.
England?
That's correct.
Oh, yeah, make sense. They eat gross food, too.
Well, you were wrong, and he was right, so you got to drink for 10 seconds.
Oh, okay.
1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, re-up. Just drink out of the can.
That's empty.
That's what I'm doing.
You could probably suck some out of the carpet from when Santa spilled it.
Oh, Rob, we're out of beer? Where? This is Santa's?
Oh, man.
You're just making me drink Santa's? That guy looks like he has an STD.
He looks like he sells plasma.
Yeah. All right.
6, 1,000, 7, 1,000, 8, 1,000, 9, 1,000, 10, 1,000.
It's right. Empty, too.
We got any more beers?
No, he asked if I... My bad.
Sailor Jerry time, buddy.
Right, Chris is going to like this.
Uh-oh. You know what's going to happen. Drunk Charlie comes out.
Oh, yeah. We're about to get mean, Charlie. Charlie's a monster when he's drunk.
Okay. All right. We're going to do one more. All right. One more.
What is Ralphie's little brother's name in the movie A Christmas Story?
Randy.
Correct. Bottoms up on that Sailor Jerry, bitch. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000. You got 2 more seconds.
No, dude. I know what we have coming up, so no. All right. That's our Christmas trivia section.
Good job, guys.
Great work, everybody.
Thank you.
Snitzer.
I didn't have my mic on the whole time. I was answering.
Why didn't you answer?
Well, it was for you two.
Bullshit. I think you should have played, and I think because of that, how much Sailor Jerry does you have to drink?
I drove it.
Like 3 fingers?
Okay, I'd say that's true. All right, Christmas Craptacular continues. We've got Weezer, the Christmas song, on 100.7.
WMMS.
The Buzzard.
Cleveland.
All right, we got it. All right.
I have a discussion that we could
launch
into.
Lead into it. All right, all right.
You don't need more beer, right?
No, I'm good.
I think Jeffrey still has almost a full one over there.
Yeah, but he drank it. Did you open it?
Oh, that's not even
No, this is the second one. I'm still on the first one.
You didn't open it?
I'm almost on with the first one, though.
Yeah, so split the second one.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, you guys can split the second one.
I don't need to be drinking.
Apply my... A lot of...
Sailor Jerry.
Santa's spill.
Jesus! How is this still happening?
Oh, for Christ's sake. Jesus Christ.
You're supposed to tap the top
that
of it.
That doesn't do anything, does it?
I mean, it worked for me.
Rob.
Kind of like that old, remember that old TV show, Hunter, starring Fred Dreyer? He has that one tagline.
It's amateur.
Works for me.
You just want to watch me clean up.
No. I just assumed
what movie?
The beer spilled.
No, you remember the old TV show, Hunter?
What time is it?
Which for the act with starring Fred Dreyer.
Okay.
Fred Dreyer?
Yeah, and he always had this one catchphrase,
Works for me.
Drop the whole bag.
It's an old TV show from the 80s.
I've never heard of any of that.
Okay.
I was alive in the 80s.
Santa got aggressive.
He did. Have you heard of a show called The Hunter with Fran Drescher?
No, Fred Dreyer, the TV show Hunter. He's a detective in some show.
Mindhunter. Yeah, he's a detective. It's like an 80s show.
Yeah, Mindhunter.
Yeah.
Oh, with Chris Angel.
Yeah, that's Mind Freak.
Oh.
And he was okay. Yeah, because he could fly. I thought that was pretty cool. But Mindhunter was great. Is that what you're talking about?
No, I'm talking about.
It just canceled on Netflix. It was like the FBI profiler show. That's what you're talking about?
I think so.
Yeah, all right, because he was trying to catch, it was great. He was trying to catch BTK, Mind Torture Kill.
Okay,
I thought it was pretty cool.
I don't really watch TV.
Oh, all right. Is that what you were talking about?
It was an old TV show because he had this one catchphrase called, works for me.
Oh, all right.
Man, imagine writing catchphrases before a bunch had been written. Like, the bar was so low. Like, you could write anything. Like, yeah, that's the phrase. Works for me.
Well, yeah, that's that. And then Sledgehammer's catchphrase is, trust me, I know what I'm doing.
Who's Sledgehammer?
He was played by actor David Rashke, and it was a cop comedy. And he's a detective.
What show?
Sledgehammer. That was the name of the show. The show's name was Sledgehammer, and that was also the name of the character.
This sounds like a fake show that would be on Arrested Development that they talk about. Sledgehammer? They had one called The Wrench or something. Anyway, so this is Sledgehammer, and what would he say?
And he always had this one saying I always like. It was, trust me, I know what I'm doing.
That's catchy as hell. Yeah, that's great. I'll have to check that out. What year was that?
That was like mid-late 80s.
Sledgehammer. All right.
He always carried a revolver with a sledgehammer on the sentinel on the handle.
Wouldn't that make it really heavy? 357
revolver.
hard to aim.
Yeah, would you do that? Wait, he had a sledgehammer on his gun?
Well, yeah, stenciled on, printed on the handle of the gun.
That makes sense.
I thought you meant on a key ring.
No. It was printed on the gun's handle.
When you go to the gas station and you asked to use the key, but in Sledgehammer's case, they asked, he asked to use the gun. And it's just attached with a big sledgehammer to make sure he doesn't steal it.
Thor.
Yeah. Okay.
That'd be tight if you had a sledgehammer that was also a gun, though. Like, you slam it down on something and it shoots a bullet out.
that would be pretty tight.
That would be tight.
All right. So, wait, you got to just... All right. So, let's start. Let's do the show again. Okay, we're back on the Christmas Craptacular. I'm your host, Charlie. What's up? I've had a little Sailor Jerry. In the commercial break or whatever that was, what you guys were listening to tunes. I don't remember what song. It was a good song, though, wasn't it? It was great.
Weezer, I think.
Sure. Yeah, Weezer. Spilled more beer that Robin's clean up. I spilled these beers 2-3 hours ago. I don't know how long. An hour ago? They just keep exploding everywhere. having a great time just hanging out with you guys for the Christmas holiday.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for having me.
Hey, no problem.
It's nice to have somebody to spend the holiday with.
Why do you? Are you alone now?
I was when I was in the car on the way here. it's a long drive, so it was pretty lonely.
Thank you for making that drive.
Yeah. Thanks for having me. Merry Snitsmas, by the way. Snits, how are you doing back there?
Oh, hey, great. Thank you, man. Thanks for having me here. This is nice. I enjoy Christmas Eve with you guys. I wouldn't ask for anything else.
Well, Rob's being really lazy. He says he's going to play this twice on Christmas Eve and twice on Christmas Day, so... It is also Christmas Day if you're listening, right? Right, Rob?
Okay. Yeah, depends on when you're listening to it.
He's using as much of this as he can.
Well, I was wondering, as I was on my long-ass drive up here, I was thinking, for adults, when Santa's making his naughty and nice list, how does he feel about, people who are sexually naughty, but they're nice people?
Ooh, who?
For example, Lizzo, I feel like she's probably a real freak in the bed.
Yeah,
so she's, sexually naughty. But she's a nice person. She's not a naughty person. She's not creating mischief or robbing people.
This is what she probably gets for Christmas is Rob got these. I asked him to give me sleigh bells and he got me this BDSM kind of cock ring.
That's about the right size.
Sleigh bells, yeah. So I think that's what Santa probably gives.
That looks a little small for you.
It does. It would only fit on a part of my butt. It's pretty cool. So yeah, I don't know. Jeffrey, who do you think's on the naughty list this year?
I don't put a lot of stock into that stuff.
No, but who do you think is?
I don't know. I mean, like I said, I don't think about stuff like that.
Do you think Santa Claus is sex positive?
I have no clue.
I think for sure. Yeah? He's been with Mrs. Claus forever.
Those elves?
He's got that team of elves.
Oh, they're getting elves in there?
That's a polygamous kind of thing they're doing.
Oh, that's freaky deaky. That is,
yeah, that's totally. And wait, Jeffrey, you have nobody on your naughty list.
Can't think of anybody.
Kanye West.
I mean, I don't even listen to him.
Vladimir Putin. Naughty or nice?
I say he's naughty because he invaded a sovereign country.
That is pretty naughty. Yeah. That is pretty naughty.
That's some heavy shit, too.
Kim Jong, which one are we on? Kim Jong-un?
Yeah, the leader of North Korea. He's you know, he's messing around and not, you know, helping his people out. He's more interested in nuclear weapons and stuff like that.
So are you officially putting him on?
Yeah, naughty list. What do you expect?
Naughty list?
Yeah. What about the FTX guy, the cryptocurrency guy who's just got arrested?
He's already after.
Was he on the naughty list?
No, yeah, naughty because they arrested him in the Bahamas. They're going to extradite him to the United States because he's got to appear before Congress.
Okay.
The Financial Oversight Committee. I've read that in the news already.
All right. Who else is on the naughty list?
Let me think. Can't think of anybody else.
Jeffrey, you're always reading the news. Who else is on the naughty? We need an official list. Who's on the nice list then?
That's a tough one, dude.
Who's nice?
I don't know, President Biden, because he's trying to help us.
Oh, we're getting political. Getting political here. All right. So if Biden is on the nice list, and I want to say this, is Trump on the naughty list?
I would say so. We'll get all the
Trump on the naughty list.
Look at all the controversies surrounding him, though. All the legal stuff that he's involved in.
Which
all
ones? Name them.
He's found guilty of tax evasion. He's facing a lawsuit from the New York Attorney General for $250 million.
Officially naughty. Hunter Biden.
I don't know. I don't know if I'm enough about Hunter Biden.
Naughty or nice?
I don't know.
Hunter Biden is sexually naughty, for sure.
I would say.
Yeah.
There is anybody in the news that I want to party with. It's Hunter Biden, right?
I don't know if I'd survive.
Oh, no, you wouldn't. No. That's how I want to go out.
I'm not at that level.
I want to be in that weird salt bath. He's smoking crack, drinking White Claws, and I'm just floating there next to him, just hanging out.
I went on one vacation where I was at like a 10% Hunter Biden kind of party level, and I almost died. Like, it's insane.
You smoked just a little crack?
No, not crack. I was in Costa Rica drunk for like 4 days straight and bought some illicit drugs that turned out to be like extra drugs that I didn't really order. I didn't realize they were on the menu.
Are we talking mushrooms, LSD?
No, I don't think he's talking. I'm thinking this is some sort of powdery drug, I'm gonna guess.
Yeah. Cocaine.
And it may have been like a language barrier thing because like I can kind of speak Spanish, but he may have told me what was in it. But yeah, it wasn't really what I expected.
What happened to you?
Like, do you want specifics?
Yeah, like, I mean.
Well, I bought what I thought.
Was this like Pulp Fiction?
Yeah.
So you have to come in and some guy and stab your heart and bring you back to life?
No, I was still conscious, but like it was heroin.
Is he on the naughty list? He just did heroin, but it was accidental.
If he didn't do it on purpose, I would put him on a naughty list. Trying
to do cocaine.
Yeah, he was trying to do cocaine.
Well, I mean, I'll leave that to his own devices.
It goes year by year, though, right? I didn't do that this year.
Oh, then you're fine. Okay. Yeah, that's
you're
not okay.
Okay.
Thank
God. You're not on the naughty list.
So, my God. So wait, did you just taste a little bit and then no?
Oh, no.
You just went
for
in,
it, yeah.
And then you went, this feels
like
different?
If it was just coke, it would have been the most coke I'd ever done. But it was both.
Oh, so it was mixed together.
Yeah.
Oh, so you got a little up. I've never done heroin in my life. Merry Christmas, everybody that's
Merry
listening,
Christmas.
By the way. This is our Christmas special, all right? So tell me about the time you did heroin.
By accident in Costa Rica. Bought drugs from a guy in an alley with no shoes and no shirt on.
Perfect.
And, you know, the rule is no service, and I should have, like, stuck with that.
Who are you with real quick?
A buddy of mine.
Just a buddy, not your wife?
No, not my wife.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, she probably would have warned us against entering that alley if she were there. Mm-hmm. So we got two bags, took it back to the hotel, mowed down the first bag, and we're like, whoa, that feels different. And
you kept going. Oh, so I thought it'd be like an immediate, like, oh, I know something's wrong. I've never done it. I don't know. I'd assume I would know immediately.
I've never, like, I wasn't like a big coke guy, so I didn't do
a
whole lot.
I'm not either, but still, you.
Well, I'm saying, like, I didn't know. I was just like, I don't know. Coke's different in Costa Rica. But, okay, so here's how I found out. So, like, afterward, I was like, man, it smells like pickles, teehee. And eventually I got home, and it was really, like, messing with me. I was like, why did it smell like pickles? Like, that didn't, I'd never experienced that before. So I Googled, like, why does my cocaine smell like pickles? And Google was like, it doesn't. That was heroin.
Oh, my God. Did you have an immediate panic attack?
No, because I was already back, like, by the time I...
Oh, so you were done doing it?
I did have a panic attack because we couldn't find the second bag. I don't know if we blacked out and did it, or, like, we were, like, we tore apart the hotel room, our luggage, looking for it.
Yeah, because you don't want to accidentally go through customs with a bag of heroin.
Yeah, dude, when I got back to the U.S., I was going through customs, and they had the drug-sniffing dog walking around me. I was sweating bullets.
So you never found it?
No. We may have just done it.
Yeah, I probably just did it. That's what you're hoping. You're hoping you did more heroin instead of going through customs. That's great. That's a great... What a Christmas miracle. Wow.
He's still alive, too.
He's still alive to tell us about it. That's great. Merry Christmas to everybody that's listening. Hey, where's Santa Claus right now? On the NORAD tracker. Go ahead. Tell us.
Unless he's out back out over Canton or something.
He's over Canton right now, right?
I don't know. Cool. I'm just guessing.
Just if your kids are listening, you just want to give you an update on where Santa is. He's over North Canton right now, right?
Merry Christmas, kids.
Merry Christmas. So, up next, we have... Am I reading this right? Dockin?
Oh, yeah. Right.
Oh, nice.
All right. We got some Dockin.
Rockin' with Dockin.
Santa Claus is coming to town on
The Buzzard.
100.7
WMMS.
Cleveland.
It's so fun to say that.
Yeah, I know. You guys are
it's also a good way to promote the radio station, too.
Oh, that's a cool way to do it.
I'm doing live imaging. How about that?
I just remembered I never wrapped my gifts.
Neither did I. So.
Oh, is gift exchange up next?
No, it's going to be the next one.
Use these bags that Santa brought.
Oh.
Or are they too big?
Well, wait. Yes, hold on.
Bags are the perfect gift wrapping solution for guys.
See, I was against the bags. During the aftermath with Charlie the other day, I ranted against those
because
it's lazy.
You do seem like somebody who'd be good at wrapping gifts, and I don't mean that in a derogatory sense.
Me?
Oh, no, it's Nick.
You're good at something. That's actually mean.
Well, no, I mean.
Jeffrey's gift.
Oh, it's in there. I can get it.
I got mine. I got the gifts I'm giving to Snitz and Charlie right here.
Nice.
Miles, just to warn you, I totally forgot to give you a gift.
I didn't know who was here.
Because he showed up unannounced. We weren't very surprised to see him here. No, because we still have one more thing to do. Then we're going to get in the gift exchange.
What are you going to do with the drum video?
I'm just going to play it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'll have the audio for that too, right?
Yeah. All right, but we're doing this video that Miles brought next, all right?
Oh, I forgot about that.
Yeah. All right, ready?
You all right, Charlie?
I've just been
Whoa.
You guys made me drink a lot of beer.
And Sailor Jerry. Sailor Jerry tastes... They're not a sponsor, are they?
We're not on the air.
Go ahead. Is that a spicy one?
Yeah, no, it's like a Captain Morgan. Like
tastes like it's already been vomited.
That's the tagline.
I don't dislike it. All my friends, they used to drink Captain Morgan, then Sailor Jerry started coming around. None of them drink Captain Morgan anymore. They all drink Sailor Jerry. I'm not a big rum guy, so I don't... Especially white... Spice rum's okay, but white rum? Ugh.
Yeah, you got to mix that with something. Yeah, that's like for pina coladas.
Yeah. All right, ready? Here we go. We're back, Christmas Craptacular on 100.7 WMMS. I'm your host, Charlie. What's up?
What's up?
With Jeffrey LaRocque, Tate Smasher, and Snitzer. Thank you guys for tuning in, spending
Merry
the holidays
Christmas.
With
Best
us.
Best of tidings.
All right, so after we just learned about Tate Smasher's heroin abuse, that was great. Thank you for sharing that.
I feel like I was the one who was abused.
Yeah. The closest I ever came was I bought ecstasy on a beach in Thailand. To turn out, I believe it was just Tylenol. That was my
Tylenol? Goal.
Yeah, so I just didn't feel anything.
I thought you were going to say meth, because that's how it always worked out in Ohio.
No. This is just I thought I was doing ecstasy, and then I was just waiting.
Growing up...
I was like, my headache's going away. This is cool. But growing up what?
Growing up in Ohio in the 90s meant, like, if you bought acid or ecstasy or... if I did, because apparently I wasn't cool enough to get the real shit. It was just always meth.
I had a friend once call me about, he calls me, you know, I'm J-Man. I love J-Man. He goes, hey, I got these roller skates. And he was living in Akron at the time. I got these roller skates. I'll sell them to you for like $20. And I go, no, why would I ever want roller skates? And then he goes, all right, $10. case of beer, and you got to come down and do my dishes. I was like, just do your dishes, Jay, man. I don't want roller skates. This was a conversation that went on for 10 minutes before I realized he was offering me ecstasy. I thought he really just had roller skates, because have you ever heard it called that in your life?
Not roller skates. I've had to refer to weed as videotapes.
I've been around that too. I've heard that too, videotapes, which is so dumb.
Okay, man, you got any videotapes?
Which is the cops listening like, oh, that guy's trying to buy $20 of videotapes? What a loser. And they know that you're just talking about weed.
Yeah, like, thank God for dispensaries. You don't have to deal with, like, these stupid code words anymore, and you don't have to watch movies with your dealer.
Yeah, I don't have my card, but I haven't been to Ohio dispensary yet. Are they just like everywhere else? Super nice?
Yeah, they're super nice, and everybody there is very helpful. What's weird about them in Ohio is they, like, measure them. They don't do, like, ounces or quarter ounces and stuff like that. It's, like, grams, I think.
No, it's not even, because Dom used to tell me about this, about whatever they were doing. It was in weird fractions that nobody uses.
Yeah, it's like, I have no idea how much I'm getting. Just whatever the thing is that costs $30, I guess. Yes. Like,
All right. Well, here's a little video Miles has prepared, Taint Smasher is prepared for us. Can you see this, Nitz, if I press play? All right. There's a little video he's prepared. If you follow Taint Smasher on Instagram, he does a lot of different drum videos. What was your popular one? One got very popular.
At Fake Real Miles, by the way.
At Fake Real Miles.
The Homer Simpson one is really big. The Beavis and Butthead one really blew
up. Beavis and Butthead.
Yeah, yes. That was on, like, news websites.
Which is sweet. Yeah. So, I don't want to take any credit. It was my idea. No big deal.
I think it was your brother's.
I was related to the person that had the idea. Anyways, no. They're very funny, all of them. The Tim Allen one. No, the Tim Allen one.
Tim Allen was huge.
That one
blew up on Twitter. Yeah, that one got like a million views on Twitter. And then I left Twitter, so it is meaningless.
Oh, you're done?
Yeah, I'm out.
Because of Musk?
No, I left because
Naughty
I was...
Naughty or nice?
Naughty.
Okay, go ahead.
Because he fucked it up.
I left before that happened because I was tired of hearing about Blink-182 reuniting.
You got to learn to use the blocked words, which I learned, and I did that for COVID vaccines. And
I tried doing that for, like, the Browns, like, way back, and it didn't work, so I just gave up on that feature.
All right, so here is a video Taint Smasher has prepared for us. Let's watch it. Here we go. He's on his drum kit. What's he got programmed into it today?
I have no clue.
Let's find out.
Check, check. Kiss my ass! I don't know if there'll be snow. Check, check. Adrenaline rush, baby. On the street. Say hello to friends you know. Everyone you meet. Kiss my ass. The tallest where you can see. Oh my God. For you. Once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas. Oh.
For a dog.
If you're just listening to him, make sure to play this on the drums.
Bobble for a dog.
It's a drum kit made out of Jeffrey songs.
Bobble for a dog. Check, shack. Oh my God. Bobble for a dog.
Do you think Michael Bublé would be proud to hear this?
Oh, I think he'd love it.
Bublé.
Bublé?
Kiss my ass. Oh, the mistletoe. It's hung where you can see. Somebody will scream. Just so once for me. Kiss my ass! And in case you didn't hear. Oh, by golly, have a holly. Check, check! Oh, my God!
For a dog.
Adrenaline rush, check, baby! Check. Oh, my God! Kiss my ass! Kiss
Wow, that's impressive. Jeffrey's even clapping.
Wow, are you impressed?
I guess so.
Wow!
It's a Christmas miracle.
That is awesome. Thank you so much for doing that special drum kit thing. That rules. Even Jeffrey's impressed. All right. We got more songs. I'm out of songs on the list. Whatever. We'll just send it to wherever, whatever Rob's about to put on. All right. Here's a Christmas song on 100.7
WMMS.
Cleveland.
The buzzer.
The buzzard.
Cleveland.
I might have skipped one or two.
Okay.
You want to do the gift exchange and then jump to the last one? Or do you want to do 945 miles?
Oh, we can skip it. I don't have, like,
just not the, all right.
A lot of content for it.
All right, so 930, not much. I don't have anything. I was just going to
okay.
You want to just combine those and wrap up?
We'll just do, the 915, and then we'll announce the next thing we're doing. It'll strictly be for RMG Plus.
Okay.
All right. Cool. All right. I love that drum kit. Welcome back to the Christmas Craptacular.
It sounded like it was farting, too.
It was. Those are some great farts you were ripping there, Taint Smasher. I'm your host, Charlie, here.
Artificial farts, too.
We're with Jeffrey. We're with Taint Smasher. We are...
Can I give a shout-out to the person who gifted me that drum set?
Yeah, who?
Piss Drinker J.
Really? Yeah. PDJ?
PDJ gave that to me.
He just gave it to you?
Yeah, he gave me the electronic kit, and so I edit like the samples and assign it to the different pads, and that's how I make the different sounds with it. But yeah, came from him.
Oh, what a great guy.
Yeah, super nice of him.
PDJ, that's great. Thank you so much, PDJ.
Thank you, buddy. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to him.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Pissmas.
I like that. All right. It's time for our gift exchange. I forgot Taint Smash was coming. Because it was a surprise, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Total surprise. So I don't have a gift for Taint Smasher.
That's okay. Don't worry about it, pal.
I'm sorry. But who wants... Jeffrey, you want to hand yours out first?
Yeah. I got... I got something for... one for Snitz and one for Charlie. I think you guys will like them.
Okay, let's find out. Where did these come from?
Got them from a little flea market out in the streets, bro.
Little flea market. Okay.
Should I come in there?
I'll take Snitz's to him.
So, yeah.
Or... if you want to come in here.
Yeah, all right.
Charlie, this is for you. Merry Christmas. It's one of the characters from Seinfeld, because I know you guys always like to quote Seinfeld.
Oh, Jeffrey, this is really nice. This is a soup Nazi. I think that's a soup. Yeah, that's him, right?
That's got to be him.
Yeah, that's the soup Nazi.
I can understand them not wanting to print that on the box.
Yeah.
Snitz, while you're here, I got one for you, too.
Okay, what do we... all right. What do we have here? The soup Nazi.
Snitz, you're a Star Wars fanatic, so I thought I'd get that for you.
Saw Gerrera.
Nice. Saw
Gerrera. Thank you, man. Appreciate
you're welcome.
I just
Merry
watched,
Christmas.
I just watched him die earlier.
Oh, spoiler alert.
What?
Everybody knows he dies.
Stop it.
You know he dies. He dies in Rogue One.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, because I was just watching... I didn't want to say Arden. Andor. I was watching Andor, so then I went right into Rogue One. Jeffrey, this is very nice. Thank you so much.
And those are collector's items, too.
Yeah, this is going right on my shelf, man.
No, I appreciate it. I've never owned a Funko Pop. I'm usually actually kind of against them and hate everybody that owns one.
Mm.
But
well, now you're one of us.
But now you have them?
Yeah, I have some. I have a Thor one, and I have a Cthulhu one.
All right, but...
But you got to, man, you can't start into that...
I'll never.
Road,
no, man. No, there's I see so these people. I see these nerds' as rooms. Is that how you say it? Nerds?
Nerds's?
Nerds's.
Yeah, nerds' as room, yeah. They have 1,000 of them. They're like, yeah, I've had to move into my mom's house because of my Funko Pop collection, but check it out. But thank you, Jeffrey. I really appreciate it. It's very nice. I love that. That was the first Seinfeld episode we watched together.
Yep, the Soup Nazi episode. When I saw that, I wasn't really... It took me a minute to figure out who it was, you know, but then I figure it's from Seinfeld. You guys make references to Seinfeld all the time, so I figure why not?
Thank you so much, Jeffrey. That's really
Star
nice.
And Snitz being a Star Wars aficionado, I thought that would be nice for him.
Thank you, man. That's awesome. Well, you know what? Here. I'm giving you yours.
All right. Here we go.
I'm sorry.
It's all good. I have a weapon, so I can just take them.
Yeah. All right, Jeffrey, what do you got?
Oh, my God. I got me a little bit of a wrestling collector's item, too. I've got the Macho Man.
Wow! Oh, it's the actual Macho Man. But is that the badass Macho Man? Is it like a different Macho Man?
This one is the version when he was in WCW.
Oh, okay, cool.
So yeah. You can different like interchange the different the heads and whatnot to like different poses and whatnot.
Oh yeah, that's really cool.
That's sweet.
Okay.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
I thought we had a limit here, Snitz. We had a limit going.
Whatever.
It's a $10 limit.
Thank you, Snitz. I appreciate it.
What is this? What is this?
I like the design on it. That's what like drew me to it.
Oh my god. Is this a ripoff Nerf gun called Zuro? So this is a Nerf gun that I could shoot Krista?
Yeah.
Oh, this is great. Well,
American flag and eagles and stuff on it.
That is so American.
This is patriotic as hell. Oh, thank you, Snitz. All right, well, now let's go into my gifts that I got everybody. You guys tried really hard. All right, Snitz, bring them in. Here we go. All right, what do we got here? This is for Snitz. Okay, yeah, we didn't wrap it, Snitz, but there you go. All right.
Jeffrey have one?
Jeffrey's got a box out there. You said there's a box out there for Jeffrey?
Oh, yeah.
All right, what do you got in there, Snitz?
Where's the... Okay, here. I'll bring it over here.
All right, what do you got in there?
Okay,
this is for me.
A collection of great stuff.
Oh, wow. That's an aloe vera leaf.
Oh, there you go.
That's pretty cool. Yeah, put that off to the side. It's really nice of me.
You got a lot of sunburns?
No, it's just talk to the mic there. Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Oh, all right, sure.
Beets?
Those are some beets? You know, that's kind of in your some food that you could eat.
Ancient grains.
I talked to the guy. Those are the most ancient grains they sell. They don't sell any older grains. Those are the most ancient.
Ginger, it looks like?
No, that's not ginger. It's turmeric? A buckaroo root.
Oh.
And one of the best buckaroo roots they had. So, yeah, I think that was the name. No, am I nowhere close? Buckaroo? It's a good root, though. That's
Brussels
a nice
sprouts?
Root. Brussels sprouts, bag of Brussels sprouts. Is that it? Yeah, I think that's it.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, there you go.
Thank you so
that's
much.
Some
really
nice
thoughtful.
Vegan, vegan foods. And tell me how that aloe vera tastes. That'll taste great.
I'm going to make some soup out of that.
Yeah, that's great. And what do we have? Jeffrey, what did I get you there?
Is it that package?
No, that's for Dieter.
Oh, okay.
Oh, thank you. To Jeff from Teen Smash.
Oh, it's from you?
Oh, no, it's from both of us.
It's from both of us. Sorry,
right,
yeah.
Well, thank you, fellas. I appreciate it.
All right, what do we got here?
Let me open it.
Yeah, I followed the limit, so I had Teen Smasher bring the gift. There was a price limit.
He paid me $10, and I paid like $100.
All right, so this is some nice stuff here. What do we
do? Do you need a knife?
I think I might need your S word.
All right. I think that might have been the best joke of the day.
That was a good joke.
What do you got in there?
Dude, she broke the internet when she said S word.
Okay, keep your hands out of the way.
All right, what do we have in this? Cut
that. Oh, this knife. Oh, my gosh.
An S word, Jeffrey called it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Ooh, tell me what you got in there.
Oh, wow. Bunch of, oh, bully. My wife's going to kick my ass. Bunch of porn DVDs.
Okay, what? Yeah, so slightly used. What names?
Thick Chicks, number two. Yeah. Sweet Ass.
That sounds great.
Oh, yeah.
Bra Bustin' Beauties.
I love that.
Yo.
I don't know if you'd show that.
Oh, yeah.
All right, it's Christmas.
See. Girls Love to Share.
Oh, that's cool.
Let's see. Perfect Porn Stars.
Vanessa Del Rio?
No, none of them are her. Taste My...
Taste your what? No, go ahead.
Taste My Cum.
Merry Christmas. Wow. Wow, so this is all from Taint Smasher's personal collection. These are highly used, I assume, right?
Heavily used, yeah.
Heavily used.
They might not even play at this point.
Yeah. So that's cool. That's you have a bustin' Christmas.
I think I saw him drool when he was looking at these.
Hey, by the way,
I'll tell you
he's ready to come down somebody's chimney.
I'll tell you what, though. What's going to happen is that I think This is something Rover could use because, you know, he's a serial masturbator.
Well, yeah, but, you know, you were trying to get your dick hard for Christmas.
Well, I'm going to see if I can sneak watch one of these. So
yeah. You're in that felon's house that's in prison right now, and you can use the big TV. right?
Yeah, but I don't think he's got a DVD player.
Oh, okay. We'll figure it out.
I'll figure something out.
We'll get something. Just watch the covers and jack off on the couch. Did you know that Jeffrey recently, he found a little gift in the couch? He's living in a felon's house. The guy's in prison.
I'm behind on the saga here.
So he's living in this guy's house. The guy's in prison. The guy, Jeffrey, was lied to.
Friend of yours?
No, it's just a guy.
Okay.
Yeah, because what happened with my housing situation, the son reached out to me and said, look, my dad's, willing to help Jeffrey out, because it was... So he moved in, and my wife, I misplaced my glasses. And in the process of looking for him, we stumbled across a couple of BB guns.
No, that's not true. You're saying it wrong. He lost his glasses in the couch. He's living in this guy's house. The guy's in prison. Jeffrey's looking for his glasses. He looks in the couch and pulls out a 44, I believe. But he said it's not
in the couch?
Yeah, and it wasn't loaded, though. Because he pulled the trigger and he looked down the barrel, so he knows.
Oh my God!
And then where would you put it after that? He put it back in the couch. Then his wife called the police on the guy that's in, called and said, "I found all these guns. Now a felon can't have guns." So he kind of called the police on this guy who's already living. Give him a Christmas shout out. He's stuck in the pen.
I don't know that there's like established house guest rules for like alerting the police to illegally owned firearms in the house, but I would say that's probably naughty list.
You're saying Jeffrey's on the naughty list for trying to get this guy?
Yeah.
They're throwing extra time on him.
I was told it was my counselor that called the police.
Okay, but the prison guy himself, is he on the naughty or nice list?
I will defer comment on that at this time.
Oh, you won't make a comment?
A comment.
No. Well, he's nice for giving you a place to live.
Yeah.
But naughty for being in prison. I'm going to go ahead and say nice list, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, nice list. All right. Well, thank you for the gifts, everybody.
Yeah, thank you.
Appreciate this gift exchange. Thank you so much for the beautiful items. It's been great spending time with you. I think that's going to probably wrap it up for our Christmas Craptacular. Except one more thing. And I don't think this is going to air on the actual, on 100.7 WMS.
Cleveland.
I don't believe it's going to air there. So if you want to see this, go over to RMG Plus. But Rob has found a secret location for us to play eggnog pong, all right?
Beer pong,
but with eggnog and rum. And that was really hard for me because I got a lot of rules here. A Taint Smasher special diet, no alcohol. Schnitzer, no eggs, I guess, whatever. So I had to get almond nog for him. So
wow. Have aloe nog?
They did not.
Damn.
So,
whisk them up later.
If you want to see this show, we'll continue for a little bit. I don't know if we're going to have microphones or what. It might just be on the phone. But if you want to see it, go over to roverradio.com, and we're going to be doing this on RMG Plus. All right. Thank you so much for hanging out for the Christmas Craptacular. I really appreciate it. Thanks to Rob for setting it up and giving us a chance to really spread our wings, and nice. For cleaning up the crap, because I'm leaving this a mess. I'm walking out.
I'm taking the sword.
Yeah, we're taking the sword. And Jeffrey, you got the dank nugs. All right, so we've really came out on top here. All right, thank you guys so much for listening. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas.
Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
All right, we'll talk to you guys soon with the regular show, Rover's Morning Glory. Bye.
Bye. Cleveland.
Okay, welcome to RMG Plus, the Christmas Craptacular here. We couldn't figure out how to do this in the studio. Keith Kennedy wouldn't let us do it in the studio. So we're in the parking garage here. Undisclosed parking garage. All right. And we're going to do eggnog pong. So, the way it's going to work. We're going to play just beer pong, basically, right? Jeffrey, you've played it?
I played it once or twice.
Okay, so it's going to be beer pong. But instead of drinking out of the cups just because it's gross, we're in a parking garage that's filled with hobo piss and shit. Instead, we're going to just drink out of our cartons instead. Now, to spice it up, real quick, Schnitzer's got his holiday almond milk nog because he has special rules. Taint Smasher's doing a thing of eggnog, but he's going to put, he suggested this, hot sauce in it. In Jeffrey's and Schnitzer, we're doing Sailor Jerry rum. That's why we got the rum, all right? So, let's go to this trash can real quick. Jeffrey, let me get your set up. Seems good. Put the rest of rum. Is that a good mix?
Is that too much, guys?
No, it's good.
Well, I'm shake it up good.
One, two,
four, oh boy, that's
five.
Was that too much?
That's
not.
Seems like it.
Okay, well.
No, that was like two shots. You're
that was like two shots.
No, why do you have to mess it up?
Okay.
Two, three,
4, 5, 6. Taste Mystery, go ahead and get yours going. And Snitz with his almond nog. It's fresh. I bought it, Snitz. Fresh. Just so you can see the labels. Seal. Yeah, seal's coming off. Can I taste this?
Get a cup.
We're out of cups.
I don't drink, so I'm using El Cholito hot sauce. Honestly, it's like good on everything, so I'm sure this is going to be delicious.
Let me see what this almond
is. It's thick. Oh, yeah. There we go. Jesus.
Actually, there almond nog?
If anything, I'm worried it might taste too good.
Smith, do you tell me to stop? I poured one more out. All right, that's good. All right, mix that up.
I gotta put my Invisalign out.
All right, we are, Jeffrey's 52, and Miles 43, right?
I'm 41.
41, 37, all right. So we are full adults playing.
Oh, look at the red in there.
Playing beer pong eggnog in a parking garage. That's what I wanted for Christmas. All right, what are teams? Anybody want to be a teammate of somebody? Say it now.
Jeffrey, what do you say?
Oh, me and Tate Snitz.
Okay, right. Me and Snitz. Okay, we're going to go an easy style of beer pong. We're not going to do any rebuttals. We're not going to do any double cups. We're not going to do any on fires.
Are you allowed, are you supposed to bounce?
Bounce counts as two. We're going to allow bounces. But if you bounce, you can swat it. Do you remember that?
Okay, sure.
That's the only thing we're doing that's special. Just usually if you go up, you can't swat it. But if you bounce, you can swat.
Okay, got it.
All right? Is that the rules?
Yeah, you can swat after the bounce.
Swat after the bounce. You're allowed to swat. So you want to kind of trick it. You guys go twice. We go twice. And that's it.
We got two balls.
Two balls. Crystal, you're on ball duty. You have to try to catch them before they end up on prospect. All right. And every time. Okay.
So when you sink a cup, like.
We're both, and usually we do it separate, but instead we're just both in chug.
Okay.
If
how long of a chug are we talking?
Healthy.
Okay, healthy chug.
Whatever would be in the cup normally.
All right.
I would say a little more. I want this to be finished by the time we're done.
All right, got it.
Okay?
Cool. All right, you want to do the honors?
Elbows don't go over. Don't worry about calories. We're playing holiday now. Okay? Elbows, you don't want to go over the edge, Jeffrey. So just try. Try your best not to. All right. Miss. All right. Miss. Let's go.
That's got some kick to it.
You probably haven't.
It tastes really good though.
How is the hot sauce not?
It actually kind of tastes pretty good.
Wait, so that one's gone now?
Yeah, it's gone. It's out of this.
Yeah, you want to get all the cups. And then you win.
Ooh. Like, I was kind of jokingly saying that it tastes good, but it actually tastes good. Alright, go for it.
I have to try to not get hit by a car here. Hold on.
Ooh! Alright. Yeah, we're not doing that rule if you hit it twice in the cup. Am I ready?
Okay, it's a lot.
Jesus. How are we doing on re-racks?
We'll do one.
One re-rack?
Whatever you want.
Alright.
Ready?
Ooh, that's two in a row.
Fucking arm on that guy.
Wow.
Are you sure this is not alcoholic?
Okay. Yeah, this is just the cheapest.
It tastes a little boozy.
That's the cheapest shit I can find. Unless you guys can switch, right?
No, that's definitely spicy.
Okay. Is that two in a row for LaRoe?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. That's some good jokes. Oh. Respect the game.
I'm feeling heavy already.
Yeah, we're going to feel heavier.
Is rum the alcohol you're supposed to put in?
Yeah.
I didn't Google it, I just guessed.
Yeah, it's definitely rum.
That
was close.
Sauce as a substitute.
I actually like the spice is kind of nice. Like it makes it feel more festive and warming. It doesn't taste bad at all. I expected it to be gross, honestly, but good combo.
Jeffrey missed.
Fuck. There's a cup there.
There we go.
If there was a cup there.
I'm going down the angle. We get three tries here, basically. Way off! Way off!
Oh, thank God. I'm gonna have to pace myself. Like two more times.
Okay. Yeah, you smell so good. How many calories are in this?
It's nice.
Well, there's 16 servings. 160 calories times 16. What is that? What's that math, Jeffrey? 160 times 16.
Oh, it's not bad. Mine's like
660? Okay, it's only 660 calories. Do you have a different number?
I don't have any number yet.
Not as bad as I thought.
16 times 160.
Fuck. 2,560.
Oh, we all missed some bitch. That motherfucker.
I think this is probably the last time I'll ever drink eggnog. End of tonight. Watch those bows!
We don't bounce.
Oh, yeah, okay. All right, I remember that rule.
Yeah, you can't just smile.
Yeah, yeah, no, you never squat. Never squat on a regular throw. Okay.
You have a ball, right?
Oh.
Oh boy.
You want to talk? I love your hour of long drive filled with hot sauce, man.
Finally, he sinks one. Oh my god. I put on the biggest shirt I own today. It's like it's stretched out.
Should I put on my winter coat?
Yeah.
Cover it all up.
Wait, here we go. Get to it. Let's just take a little more. All right. Jeffrey, yours is pathetic looking, by the way, compared to my Elvis.
Oh.
Yeah, dude.
Come on, Jeffrey.
That was never much of a problem.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Yes!
Nice.
No. Get it down. Jeffrey, I want to see some actual chugging. Put that thing up. Put it up, Jeffrey.
There you go.
Oh, yeah, Jeffrey.
That's better.
All right. Oh, yeah, get rid of that one.
Oh.
This makes fun.
Do you want a re-rack?
Not yet. We will.
Oh, I see.
Look at there. Let Snitzer hit it first. Snitzer's going to hit it. Oh! Get that thing up there. Get that thing up there. Push that thing up.
Oh, my God. That's not a good feeling. I always thought people were, like, joking when they said they were lactose intolerant. Apparently, if you drink enough of it.
Re-rack, we're gonna do a small. You want the line? You can try. Here we go. Ready? Race it. Oh! Suck my fucking dick. Sorry, guys. Not you guys.
Oh, yeah, Jeffrey. Yeah, Jeffrey's there, man.
I literally don't have much life.
It's leaking out of Jeffrey.
All right, that one's out. I feel like I just swallowed a hive of bees.
Oh!
Here you go. Come on, let's put a hurt on him. Oh,
yep, game.
Oh, there's the fresh curve.
What are we gonna play the fucking game with that?
Oh, sick. I'm not picking this up.
Oh. It didn't touch the peel.
Well, disgusting.
I'll break my phone.
I wasn't expecting it. I was like, I can hold it back a little bit, but now I feel good. I blew a little off the top, a little steam out, vented a little bit.
Calories are back here.
Okay, what version do you guys want?
It's a triangle.
Like a pyramid?
Yeah.
Oh, it's fucking shaky. It's so hard to hold this camera.
It's the same shape.
Yes, you're right. Okay. For some reason, I'm thinking an oblong triangle. All right.
I
think it's not.
That's clean enough. Oh, shit.
All right, one more. Wait, did you already make it? Is it my turn?
Oh, no, he's got it.
God.
I made it.
Oh, okay. We already went twice. Nice.
Oh. Oh, your shoes.
Kennedy wanted to do this in the studio.
I even offered him. Yeah, it's hard.
That's pretty lame of him. All right. Get it. Close this out. I don't want to drink anymore. Jeffrey's on the peel. Jeffrey, get in the car!
I thought over your shoes anyway.
We have puke in our bounce zone, by the way.
Oh, geez, that went up puke! Why are you staying way over there?
Watching this on the show was one thing, but in person it's a million times worse.
Oh, okay. Kevin Stitz, end this. Close.
It's a death note.
It's a death note. Oh, my God!
I need more than that.
Yeah, that's all for just one pile. There's like washing four piles.
There's four.
I don't know. What am I going to do?
You got a drink.
Thank you guys so much for the Christmas craptacular.
They gave her a taint masher,
snitz.
What are the odds of us seeing puke in the hallway?
I pray to God he makes it.
Well, Rob just told me he saw an actual a human shit in the hallway. Yeah. Tell us about that.
I wasn't responsible for that one. I am for this one, so okay. Let's hope he doesn't do it.
All right, we'll be back. Thank you guys so much for subscribing. We'll be back, I don't know, beginning of the year or whatever. Thanks. Bye.
Christmas.